The Pacific Southwest Research Station is a branch of the Forest Service Research Organization, and we're part of the USDA Forest Service. And we conduct research related to forests in California and Hawaii and the Pacific Islands. The mission of the Pacific Southwest Research Station is to conduct research to allow us to better the management of the public lands, primarily the forests, and conduct all aspects of research, from wildlife to water to air to fire to trees, you name it. We cover all aspects of that research.
We play a vital role in research because we focus on long-term research, looking at how forests have changed over a long period of time. And we also have access to areas like this, an experimental forest, where research has been ongoing for a very long period of time.
One of the critical aspects of the success that we have in our fire program is that many of our scientists have a unique ability of working hand in hand with many of our land managers, particularly from our national forest system, and particularly from the region here.
We have close ties to the land management agency, of which we're part, and we also have the detached ability, much like our university cooperators do, to conduct research objectively and to address problems which are of interest both immediately and in the future related to land management of this country.
The Stanislaus Tuolumne Experimental Forest is one of our nation's areas for doing research on national forest lands.
The changes I've seen in forests over the last 20 years is primarily where they're starting to see the effects of actually many decades of fire suppression, which has brought about increasingly dense forests over the last 100 years from the way that they used to be.
I think that vigor is down, and trees are less resilient, essentially. And that, combined with the fact that we have overstocking and higher surface fuel loads, we have the potential for uncharacteristic wildfires in these forests.
We know today that fire behaves very differently. The dense forests that we have today allow the fire to increase in intensity. There's a lot more fuel on the ground than there was when the fires were coming through frequently, and the fuel allows the fires to build up intensity, which then pushes them up into the understories, the small trees in the underneath, and then up into the crown.
We know that fire is a very integral part of these systems, and we've suppressed it for many years, and so we have a high intensity fires when they occur these days.
Fire can be a friend and a foe. Really, fire is just a disturbance which occurs, it naturally occurs in vegetation.
Fire is vital for many ecological processes in these forests.
Fire used to burn through the understory of forests and take out a lot of the regenerating trees. Hasn't been able to do that since we started doing real effective fire suppression. As a result of that, when fires get started in those forests, instead of burning on the ground and just burning up the little trees and the bushes and the accumulated pine needles and things, instead, the fire can climb up through the regenerating vegetation into the crown and become the sort of Holocaust fires that you see on the evening news. Densification of the forest due to this increase in numbers of trees because we've been putting out fire so effectively has really caused an increase in fire. Seems like a contradiction, but that's what's been happening.
Well, what I'd really like the public to know is how important these things that we're doing are, especially, you know, thinning of these forests that are completely overstocked from what they historically were, and also, again, reintroducing fire, that not all fire is bad. You know, wildfire that's uncontrolled can certainly be devastating to communities, but I think it's really important for people to understand that fire is an important part of the ecosystem. It was a very regular part of the system historically, and that for us to reintroduce it is really an important part of ecological restoration of these forests today.
I think that some folks think that we can put everything out that happens, or that we should be able to, and in fact we cannot eliminate fire from these forests. So we have to learn to live with it, and live with it more or less on our terms if we can, rather than the extreme terms that nature sort of dictates.
The thing that I'm proudest of in terms of my personal research has been the team that I work with that is really focused on fire behavior and trying to understand how fire spreads in live fuels.
I'm very excited about the work we're doing here on the Stanislaus Tuolumne Experimental Forest because we have developed a very strong relationship with the National Forest System here. And as a result, our work that we're doing is very easily transferred to management where they can use it, and we're already seeing that work being used today.